companies leaving the city.
Thank you. Ms. Fritz?
Well, I was just at a manufacturing summit that the chamber put on in Carroll, and there were four or five different manufacturing facilities and CEOs who were there, and they all agreed they need workers. They need educated workers. There's a huge gap. There, again, there are some of those folks that work in manufacturing are 55, 65 years of age and will be retiring. We do not have enough of those young people taking those classes. So fortunately, South Central College, that I was able to find and fund money for. My opponent said he would not have funded that. I found and worked hard for 8 years to get that school expanded and giving opportunities to those students that will have those jobs. And those people that own those manufacturing firms will have educated workers.
Thank you. Ms. Cashman?
I think the legislature started this year in offering some good incentives to companies and the angel investment and jobs creation and things with companies that have incentives to hire veterans. Taxes come up all the time, and I think we do need to look at the corporate tax. I think we could look at that. But again, we do have fine workers here, and people come here and know the strong work ethic, and also that we do need better training and to arrange. Medford just received a $10,000 grant, and it's called Ramp It Up, and they're working with their students from 7th grade through 12 now this year on really focusing on a career and helping them find that. Also, there's is it Dakin in town that got $800,000 from a grant, and they have a sign up that says now hiring.
Thank you. Mr. Petersburg.
Well, it's certainly not just taxes, although that would sure go a long ways to it. We have to also look at why our companies being bought out by foreign countries coming here. That's a federal issue as to the climate and the inflation and the value of the dollar here in the United States. But also, I think you started to allude to, it's all of the other resources. Personnel capital is one of those, but it's also things like energy and our energy procedure policies. Almost every business has a major industry or a involvement with energy. And yet there's a big push to say, well, big business or business in general can distribute extra costs a little bit more so we can keep regular energy rates low. Well, bottom line is we all end up paying for that because they'll just tack on that cost to the services that we buy. So I think we need to look at all the rest of it as well, but we need to first of all figure out how we can reduce the tax burden because we can live within our means. I know we can.
Thank you. We're going to have, I do apologize to those whose questions I did not get to today, but we are simply running out of time. But we are going to have one final question. The question you should be able to answer in just a few words, candidates. Mr. Petersburg, we'll start with you. And realizing that you are busy on the campaign trail, candidates, and you may not have as much time as you would like, nevertheless, we're going to ask the question. The question we've asked all candidates, what book are you reading now? Mr. Petersburg.
Bible.
Ms. Cashman.
I just finished The Target by David Baldacci.
Ms. Fritz.
Oh, the Irish saved civilization. I recommend.
No clapping, Mr. Shea. Mr. Daniels.
My regular pleasure reading has not happened for about 4 months, so right now I'm concentrating on Jesus Calling. It's a daily scripture.
Thank you. And candidates, we have reached the end of our formal questioning, so to wrap up the discussion, we will allow each candidate 2 minutes for final thoughts. Ms. Cashman, we will begin with you.
Begin with me. I've knocked on a lot of doors. I've been knocking since July 12th, and I've heard a lot of concerns of people that I had no idea that were out there, things that I had never thought about and things that people are struggling with that I was unaware of. I'm looking for that opportunity to represent you and to represent all the people of our district and to bring prosperity here through business and through fairness, and to really be that representative for all people, and not just representing one political party and voting a certain ideology, but looking at, talking to, and saying, how can, as a representative, I make this a better place, and how can I have an impact, how can government not interfere, but be helpful in people's lives? And so, again, I can't have that opportunity if people don't vote. And so, first of all, I'm encouraging everyone to go out and vote, and to look for that person who is truly representative.
Thank you. Mr. Petersburg.
Thank you. I also am, I think all of us up here have worked hard. And if you haven't seen us, we're been behind the scenes, but we're all working hard. I think it's one of the things that I really strive for is my willingness and my desire to serve this community. My background with church politics and really learning how to get people together is one of the things that I really strive for. It's one of the things that I think God has gifted me with, the ability to really work with others and individuals and bring forth the best solution. But I know that all of you are asking for us to work hard and do the best for the community. And I know that we aren't always going to be able to satisfy everybody or be able to vote exactly the way everybody would like us to do that. That's just impossible. But I can tell you that we're all very earnest, and I'm very earnest about my doing the best job that I can to reflect your views and the views of the state and what's best for all of us concerned. And that means that we need to have a government that is willing to empower people rather than to just be a solution.
Thank you. Mr. Daniels.
Thank you. Thank you for the chamber for the invite. Appreciate that. This is my first time running for major office, so I feel a little bit like a fish out of water. But I have served my communities up north, doing numerous things for the church, for friends and family. And after my surgery, I was not able to do most of the things that I did before. And right now, I've got my children raised. They're okay. They're doing very well. All of them are graduated their college degrees. Well, actually, my youngest son is December. He's graduating. So I'm very proud and thankful for that. But my children are raised, and I'm used to giving back to the community. But this my physical abilities have been limited, so this might be an avenue for me to be able to give back to the community in an even larger way. And I'm a very hard worker, a very honest man. What you see is what you get. And I would do everything in my power of elected to make sure that we take care of our elderly. I think that's really super important. Take care of our roads and bridges. We just have to set priorities, and we have to make sure to fund those priorities. And I would do everything in my power to do that. I'm going to be learning. I do have some good people there that will help me get started. Like John said, as a freshman, there's a lot to learn, and I know there's a lot to learn. This last 4 months, I thought would be the most scary of my life. My sister asked me to run way back in February. She's the representative from Buffalo, and I was scared to death. And I tell you what, I've knocked on about 10,000 plus doors, and I enjoy it. In fact, if we have time this afternoon, we'll go out for a couple hours. But I enjoy meeting the people, what their concerns are, and this ride that God's put me on has been the best ride I've ever had.
Thank you. Ms. Fritz, you have the final word.
Well, thank you, and thank you, Jeffrey, and all of you again for the invitation to be here today. These are good questions. This was fun, even the lightning rod questions I enjoyed. And I do enjoy meeting with the folks that I serve, the constituents here that I serve. But I enjoy serving. I do believe that for me, it's as a nurse and a mother and a grandmother and a wife, I have had the opportunity to become a good listener. And I've listened to many people from all walks of life. And I do take that back with me. And I feel that I connect with the people that I serve. And I'm able to be a voice for you in the legislature. My first year, I was very fortunate, and when I was elected, I was actually in the minority. So I had a lot of time to listen and learn. And I have been there now a number of years, but I'm still hardworking, I'm still determined, and I'm still passionate, and I'm honored to serve and represent you in the House of Representatives. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And can we have a round of applause? And at this point, I will turn it back to Chris Boosie.